Have the Bible documents been corrupted? Weren't the stories in the Bible changed and written down hundreds of years after the events that it describes? Recently, I had a conversation with a young man who told me the reason he doesn't come to church is because the Bible has been corrupted. The version of the Bible we have today, he said, is not the same as the original, but it's been changed by scribes and by people who lived hundreds of years later who had their own agendas. This is actually a favorite excuse I found, especially with people from a Muslim background, as to why they do not believe and read the Bible. But this question is actually relatively easy to answer for anyone who spent time investigating the evidence on the historicity and the authenticity of our modern Bible. So what is the Bible? Well, the Bible is the world's best-selling book. It consists of 66 individual books by over 40 authors, written over more than 1,600 years in three languages on three continents. And when we talk about the Bible as an ancient book, or really about any kind of ancient book, we're looking for manuscripts. What is a manuscript? Well, a manuscript is a copy of the original work as it was written down. With most ancient documents, we do not have the original documents as it was written. They've been lost to time, but we have copies of the original, written and copied by hand by scribes, usually decades or a few hundred years later. And the more manuscript evidence you have for an ancient document, the better you can attest its modern authenticity. The good news for those serious about the Bible is that the New Testament specifically has more than 5,000 current ancient manuscripts that scholars know of, and new are being discovered basically every year. A lot of these manuscripts are also not very old. They were written or found soon after the events that they describe. The Bible really is attested by manuscripts better than just about any other historical document than I know of. There's good evidence, for example, that the Gospel of Mark, which is the earliest gospel in the New Testament, was written just 35 years after the events it describes. And the Gospel of John, which is the oldest gospel, was written 60 years around AD 90, around 60 years after Jesus's life. So go ahead and ask your grandmother and grandfather if they remember significant events from 60 years ago. They will probably remember it, often in great detail. The Bible scholar Amy Orr Irving did incredible research where she looked at the names and the geography and even the botany of the New Testament, the plants and the trees being described. And she showed that it is clear that these documents, the Gospels in the New Testament specifically, were written by people who lived and grew up in these areas. They weren't written by different people hundreds of years ago, hundreds of miles away, but of people who knew the land and who knew the culture and wrote these Gospels. The one-time director of the British Museum, Sir Frederick Kenyon, once said the following. He said, "Both the authenticity and the general integrity of the books of the New Testament may be regarded as finally established." The Bible was not written hundreds of years later, after the events it describes, by people who had nothing to do with it. Anyone who says that hasn't looked at the evidence.